Welcome to Rosedale College, where education means excellence. My school is situated in the heart of Hayes, where life is abundant with possibilities and opportunities. Year 7, we are really looking forward to embracing you into our community, a community where responsibility, respect and resilience is but a few of the attributes we expect from our flourishing students. Here at Rosedale College, we ensure all students are consistently making progress, both academically and personally. Sporting and creative talents and nurturing is also second to none here. Here at Rosedale College, we not only nurture talent, support requests, but we also challenge our students to make sure that we always get the best out of them. Your success is considered our success. Unsurprisingly, the college is oversubscribed because of our unique way of both teaching and learning. We look forward to meeting you lucky ones who make it to join our lovely community. Looking forward to seeing you here at Rosedale College next year. My name is Mrs. Kapadia and I am the principal here at Rosedale College. Students make outstanding progress during Key Stage 3 and 4, regardless of their ability or starting points when they join the college. Progress in lessons is good. This is a fantastic accolade that we have received from Ofsted due to the contributions that the staff offer the students at the college. The college day for your child will consist of 6 periods. They will have 2 registration opportunities throughout the day, and that is to ensure that we offer the best pastoral care possible. Students will have break, and they will also have a 45-minute lunch to ensure that they get to enjoy a hearty meal and then spend some time outside as well. Being safe. Students feel very safe and say that matters that they bring to the attention of adults are dealt with quickly and effectively. We are very eager to make sure all students in the college feel safe. All students are made aware of where they need to go and who they need to speak to make sure that they are able to share their thoughts and their feelings and, most importantly, any concerns that they may have. Inclusive environment. We have been described as being caring and inclusive by the Inclusion Quality Mark. We are very fortunate and very proud of the fact that for the second year in a row, we have retained our flagship status in the Inclusion Quality Mark. It is with great pleasure that I share with you that we are also now on track to get the Arts Mark. The college is one of the best schools in the country at outperforming expectations for their pupils and improving their future prospects, as recorded and reported by SSAT. It is really important to understand that as a college, we make sure that students outperform expectations. We don't think about where they started, but our focus is solely on where they will end. We want to make sure that all of our students are employment ready. Academic achievements. Once again, our A-level results show a noticeable and a continued upward trajectory. We put extensive provisions in place to make sure that we not only support but also stretch students to get the best out of them. One of the ways that we have found to be really successful to make sure that students are motivated and inspired is by inviting previous students who have been successful back to the college to speak to them. The college has a proven track record of adding value to students' overall attainment and achievement. We have been really lucky that even during these testing times, so many of our students have gone on to pursue undergraduate courses at some really reputable universities, as well as going on to do apprenticeships. GCSE courses. Our GCSE courses again show an upward trajectory, which is a true testament to the highly motivated and committed staff. Vocational subjects also continue to offer students exceptional success and open doors for future employment. We are really eager to make sure that students are employable. We're really eager to make sure that they are employment ready. The staff have obviously gone above and beyond over the last 18 months to make sure that they do right by Ofqual, but they also do right by our students. They've worked really hard to ascertain the right grade for the right student. The progress of all students is evaluated regularly so that any gaps in their understanding are identified and additional support is quickly arranged. This ensures that all pupils make rapid progress towards their individual targets. It is really important for all of us to understand that we are eager to make sure that students are constantly making progress. All students need to make progress, and that is our aim collectively. The Rosedale Huins Academy Trust. Rosedale College is the flagship school for the Trust. Part of the Trust, we have Huins College just across the Uxbridge Road. We have Parkside Studio College, who are on our campus, and we also have DeSales Studio College, who are across the college as well, across the Uxbridge Road as well. It is a real advantage to have these three schools as part of our network because we can work alongside them, we can work with them, and they can support us just as much as we can support them. I highly recommend that you check out Parkside Studio College and DeSales Studio College, where education begins from year 9. We also have three feeder primary schools within the Trust: Rosedale Primary on our site, Huins Primary just across the Uxbridge Road, and Brookside Primary, which is less than a mile away. Having an insight into the primary education allows us to make sure that we build on what they already know and we continue to support and aid that revision and that understanding. Coronavirus safe. The college continues to provide a safe setting for staff and students. All necessary precautions are in place and they have been in place throughout the entire pandemic. We did really well making sure that we offered high quality and live virtual lessons each and every day. A student's timetable did not change during the pandemic because they were following their normal timetable and staff were also following their timetables to ensure that they were getting at least 6 hours of live lessons a day. I think that made sure that we continued to make progress with our students. We were in contact with them and they remained in contact with us. The college site. The college has been earmarked for a site rehabilitation program, SRP, a grant to upgrade and modernize our main building. We are working very closely with the Department for Education to secure this funding and are hoping for a start date during this academic year. Some important dates to remember. Parents, guardians and carers, you are all encouraged to apply online. Just a gentle reminder that you can choose up to 6 preferences. The deadline for closing admissions is Sunday, the 31st of October. Offers will be made for school places to all parents, guardians and carers on Tuesday, the 1st of March, and then on Tuesday, the 15th of March, except that is your acceptance deadline. Please remember that Rosedale College is an oversubscribed school, so we are really eager to make sure as many of you get the right places as possible. Finally, why Rosedale? We have fantastic teachers, amazing GCSE results, good A-level results, outstanding sporting facilities, interesting vocational courses, exciting extracurricular clubs, effective support provisions, and we offer the opportunity for astonishing excursions. Students at Rosedale College have been to Italy, Poland, and France, and now with the pandemic showing some sort of relief, we are hoping to make sure that children can get out and about. We want to bring learning to life for all of our students. We look forward to welcoming all of you to Rosedale College in September 22. Thank you.
Welcome to Rosedale College. I'm here to present the new IT suite that we have now because we have new PCs and new software that we can use. And here we now have the latest Adobe suites and the latest Microsoft Office suites, where we can use Microsoft Teams if we need to do some online work, or if we just want to do our work on IT, like doing e-safety or any of our courseworks for us to do. Here this young man is using Word, where he's able to talk about the objectives that he needs to do for his business project. And here he's using Excel from Microsoft Office, where he's able to access what he needs in order to do his task. He's also using Microsoft Word, where he's listing his objectives that he needs to do for his task. Here this young gentleman is using Adobe Dreamweaver, which is our latest Adobe software that we can access, and he's using this to design a website for the task that he needs to do.
Welcome to English Alliance. Come and see what we do here.
This looks interesting. Why don't we take a look?
Okay, sure.
Good morning, team.
Good morning, Inspector.
As you can see, there was an incident last night and we have our victim here. There are three pieces of evidence at hand currently. Evidence one.
There seems to be a ticket to the theatre.
True.
That seems like a baby scan.
Indeed.
It seems like a bleach ball.
We have the theatre ticket, we have the baby scan, and we have the bottle of bleach. There were developments last night, team. Therefore, I have four additional pieces of evidence to hand to you. Additional one. Additional two. Additional three. Additional four. Team, you are my best officers and my best investigators. I have chosen you specifically for this case. It is complex and it's difficult, but I expect results and I expect the case to be cracked. I need you, please, to go away. I need you to analyse the additional pieces of evidence you were given, along with the three pieces of evidence before you. I want to know, team, what happened, when it happened, why it happened, and how it happened. It's down to you. Off you go.
Team, I think I found some evidence. This letter is a dismissal effective immediately. The circumstances surrounding your dismissal are as follows. A customer has made a complaint against you, citing impertinent and incorrigible behavior. As such, please ensure that you take all personal belongings with you. Maybe she got fired from her job.
On my evidence, it says that she was fired in September.
It seems here that she had received a letter from the woman's charity organization. It reads, to whom it may concern, this letter to inform you that after careful consideration, your appeal to the Bromley Women's Charity Organisation has been denied. Please note that your application cannot be considered at any other time. Yours sincerely, the Women's Charity Organisation, Bromley.
But team, I don't get it. In her certificate of death, it says she was single, but somehow she was pregnant. And it doesn't really say if she was divorced or not, so how are we going to figure this out?
We've got this. We have to do it and we're going to get this, so.
In English, we do a lot of oral activities such as debating, speeches and presentations. Today we are debating about whether a person should change their personality or not. They are for and we are against.
Firstly, I believe that as a person grows, they like to discover new things and they have new beliefs.
contradict your point. Everybody has a destiny, and if they come away from that destiny, that means they are like throwing their life away. For example, say if I was five, and then I take a different route for my destiny and my life goes bad, that's just wasting my life.
On the other half of my partner's point, you could be when you change, you most likely change into a better better version of yourself. This means that you're advancing into life.
However, life is hard, and if you're changing for life, you're changing into a bad person.
Thank you for joining our debate. Come join our school to see what happens next.
In English, we also study poems, but not just that, we also write our own poems and they can get published. For example, I'm going to read a snippet of my poem called Superheroes, which was published in the anthology Through Their Eyes. You may or may not know it, these heroes are all for it. Hold your trust in them, for surely they will be grateful when you fly your nest and remember them. Your teachers, parents and guardians are the best. They are the real superheroes, fighting for your progress and nothing less. Respect them for success.
Welcome to the Humanities Alliance, where we educate not only minds, but hearts. Now let's listen to our students as they tell you about what we have to offer.
Not only does citizenship help our knowledge on laws, legal actions, but also helps develop our self-confidence and our knowledge on the world while promoting British values. It helps give us our voice not only in our school lives, but also our communities and the world. That's why it's important to be an active citizen and play your part. Will that be you?
Let's talk about history. History helps us learn about the past, and it also shows us how the past affects our day-to-day lives. Without learning from the past, are we not doomed to repeat the mistakes of our ancestors?
In RE, we learn about different beliefs and different practices of different religions. Our religious education aids our personal development and provides a foundation for our spiritual, moral, social, and cultural questions that we face in everyday life. Our RE lessons promote cohesion, teaches us tolerance, and promotes self-respect, and contribute to our understanding of history and culture.
Geography is a vital subject to help humans understand the basic physical systems in everyday life, such as water cycles and ocean currents. For example, geography helps promote the awareness of the planet's changes, planet's movements, nature resources and water availability, and much more. We must care for the planet, and in exchange, the planet will care for us.
So the Humanities Alliance welcomes you as you prepare to achieve your life goals by learning these exciting subjects.
Welcome to the Language Alliance. Here are some fun experiences that we have been doing.
Bonjour tout le monde. Ça c'était un match. Tu as bien joué.
Bonjour, oui. J'ai bien joué. L'équipe a bien joué.
Qu'est-ce que tu fais pour rester en forme?
Je m'entraîne chaque jour. Je joue au foot chaque jour. Aussi, je mange sain. Je mange des fruits et des légumes.
Bonjour, Hussein. Ah, alors, tu es frère de ton équipe.
Bonjour, Marie Lohmann. On a bien joué.
Bonjour.
Bonjour, monsieur. Que désirez bien.
Je voudrais du tomate.
Oui, monsieur.
Aussi, je voudrais une baguette. Et encore du pomme. Finalement, je voudrais une salade.
Voilà.
Voilà.
8 euros, s'il vous plaît.
Au revoir.
this is the STEM building. We're going to go into the technology room and we're going to be looking at mechanical cars.
Welcome to the Rose Cafe. I am a Year 10 student who is also the manager of the Rose Cafe. Please follow me this way.
I am a Year 10 student and I am the assistant manager of the Rose Cafe. Key Stage 3 students have 2 food technology lessons per week. All ingredients are provided by the school. Here are some samples we have made.
So this is the barbecue chicken which I'm making. This is the sauce which I'm going to baste the chicken with, and then I'm going to put it back in the oven. Do it so that it enhances the flavour and so that all the meat and the juices go through to the chicken, and so the flavour becomes better and bigger. Gives it that real authentic barbecue taste. And now I'll put it back in the oven.
Today we are icing the chocolate cake that we're going to serve at the Rose Cafe. We're icing this cake because it's going to be very tasty once we serve it.
One thing I like about Food Tech is the different foods that we can use to make new meals. We do this every Thursday and every other classes that we can. We also love our lovely teacher, she helps us with everything.
We also have Club Elite, and I am the president of the club. The club takes place every Thursday after school, and this is the vice president.
We have many different functions for parents and staff that take place in winter and summer.
As a part of Club Elite, we learn different cooking techniques and different recipes from different cultures. What I enjoy most is the friendly atmosphere and how well we work together as a team to achieve one goal.
This is the final product that we made. We achieved this by working together as a team.
Thank you.
Would you look at those? Gorgeous. They look delicious. They're so good. I can't wait for you to try it and have a taste.
Right. Today we're going to be bartenders.
Really? So what are you going to be serving us?
We're going to have regular wine, and then we're going to turn this red wine into fizzy lemonade, into milk and a milkshake. We're even going to turn it into water.
Really? Red wine into water?
It's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah. So why don't you start?
Our regular red wine, then the fizzy lemonade, milk, the milkshake, and our water.
This is awesome. We don't just get to learn about the scientific equipment, but we get to use it as well.
Look at that. Wow, this cell membranes are really cool.
Let me take a look. Oh, what? The shape of the cell looks so different. I love it.
Learning about the body can be very interesting, especially when we have real organs to help us learn. As you can see, I am going to dissect a sheep's heart. As you can see, the left side is thicker than the right side. This is because this part pumps the blood all the way to the all through the body, and this part pumps it only to the lungs. This is how it looks on the inside. These are one of the opportunities that I've been able to have at Rosedale, and you can have it too if you come here.
Did you know that chemical reactions are really cool?
No, not really. So
here, look, I'll show you.
Whoa, how did that happen? What's so interesting about that? They look like water. Oh, wow. They turned white. I doubt anything will happen to this one. Can I try another one?
Yeah, you can do the last one.
They turned yellow. This looks like paint. Maybe you were right. Chemical reactions are interesting.
Hey, come here. So I learned something really interesting today.
What did you learn today?
Well, I was doing a chemical reaction, and I learned that a clear substance and a blue substance turn into this. Look, half solid, half liquid.
Wow, that looks really cool.
Right? And a clear and an orange turn into this. Looks like it's blood, doesn't it?
Love the colour.
Two clear substances also turn into this. It looks like there's gum in there.
That looks really white.
Right? And this is the best one. This is mine. I did this. Two clear substances turn into this. It's yellow. It's like paint.
That looks like yellow as the sun.
Right? So I think it was very interesting. At first, I thought it wasn't that cool, but change my mind. Chemical reactions are cool.
I like the spacing reaction. I'm going to get silver to form over this copper wire. As you can see, the wire starts to darken.
Physics is absolutely amazing. You get to use real-life equipment like circuits to investigate factors. You can use light bulbs, motors, buzzers, and make new circuits and investigate new things.
This is a series circuit and this is a parallel circuit. In a series circuit, you can use these two wires and turn on the bulb, or you can put the wires over here and turn on the bulb with a higher voltage and a sound.
This is a parallel circuit. Now in the parallel circuit, as the power bank is powering the bulb and the bulb is only working but the motor isn't, because there is a switch that prevents it from making noise and also helps it make noise as well.
Hi, welcome to our school sports hall. This is where we do a lot of our indoor sports. Right here we have table tennis, cricket and badminton.
Hi, I'm a Rosedale College student and I really like the PE lessons here because I get to compete against my friends and do loads of different fun sports. I even got the opportunity to compete in Borough Athletics, where I had a really fun time and made lots of new friends.